said, cry. And he said, what shall I cry? All flesh is grass, and all the goodliness thereof is as the flower of the field. The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, but the Spirit of the Lord bloweth upon it. Surely the people is grass. The grass withereth, the flower fadeth, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Father God, Lord, I thank you.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, I ask that you anoint me today.
Yes, Lord.
Bring forth your message, Father.
Hallelujah.
To bring comfort to your people.
Yes,
to encourage your people, Lord.
Glory.
To keep on pressing forward, Father. And I'll never fail to give you the praise, the honor, and glory for God.
Yes,
in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
So as I was studying this, as I was reading this, I felt like God was telling us the battle is hard. The battle is hard. And it is. We're being attacked by sickness. We're being discouraged by numbers that keep going up. We're being held hostage, I feel like, sometimes. By lies, by deceit. There is so much deceit. And there are so many people that are believing it tonight. And I just get so, and I'm like, Lord, what do we do? He said, keep speaking my word. Keep believing my word.
Yeah.
Keep using my word and keep on fighting.
Yes. Hallelujah.
You see, it's not over with yet.
No.
It's not over with till he parts the skies.
Yeah. Come on.
That's what it's over with. So we got to stand firm. And we got to keep believing that no matter what, he has our back. Amen.
Amen.
Sir, no matter what letter you get in the mail, he's got your back.
Right.
He's got your finances.
Yeah.
He's got your health. He's got your children. Amen.
Amen.
You see, I've been real frustrated this week. I'm going to pick on my boys. They move football practice to 5:30 to 7. What do they do all day? They sleep. So when I get home from work, I'm in a run to try to get two half-grown boys out of the bed and dressed for football practice. I get real frustrated, especially on church night. Because I'm trying to prepare Wednesday night is for me to bring forth the word, right? So it's a fight from the time I get out of bed. The headache this morning. The nausea this morning. But I kept on pressing. I got him out of bed. And I told him today, today's the last day I wake him up. Because we have to take responsibility.
Amen.
We have to take responsibility for our salvation.
Yep.
We have to take responsibility for the battle that we've been placed in.
Amen.
You see, we are God's soldiers. So tomorrow, if they're not up at 5 o'clock, I'm going to sit down at the table and I'm going to enjoy my evening. Then they can explain to their coach why they didn't make it to practice.
Amen.
Just like if we don't keep up the battle, if we don't keep up our reading, if we don't keep up our praying,
yeah,
then we'll explain to God one day.
Come on.
And he's going to turn us away.
Yeah.
Excuses.
Come on.
Right?
Yeah.
There's no excuse. So I want to use this chapter tonight to encourage us. Let's go on a little farther. O Zion, that bringest good tidings, get thee up into the high mountains. O Jerusalem, that bringest good tidings, lift up thy voice with strength. Lift it up, be not afraid. Say it to the cities of Judah, behold your God. Behold, the Lord God will come with strong hand, and his arm shall rule for him. Behold, his reward is with him, and his work before him. He shall feed his flock like a shepherd. He shall gather the lambs with his arm, and carry them in his bosom, and shall gently lead those that are with him. Sounds pretty awesome, don't it?
Amen.
Go over to verse 21. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Hath it not been told from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is he that sitteth upon the circle of the earth, and the inhabitants thereof are as grasshoppers, that stretcheth out the heavens as a curtain, and spreadeth them as a tent to the wilderness, that bringeth the princes to nothing. He maketh the judges of earth as vanity. Yea, they shall not be planted. Yea, they shall not be sown. Yea, their stock shall not take root in the earth. And he shall also blow upon them, and they shall wither, and the whirlwind shall take them away. So why do we worry? Why do we worry about the enemy? God has our back, right?
Amen.
Verse 25 says, to whom then will you liken me? Or shall I be equal, saith the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high, and behold, who hath created these things, that bringeth out their host by number. He calleth them all by names, by the greatness of his might, for he is strong in power, not one faileth. Why sayest thou, O Jacob, and speaketh, O Israel? My way is hid from the Lord, and my judgment is passed over from my God. Hast thou not known? Hast thou not heard? That the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no mind, he increases strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. And they shall walk and not faint. That's my God.
Amen.
That's who I serve.
Yeah.
So no matter what, no matter what's coming against me, no matter how weak I get, all I gotta do is say, Lord, I need your strength.
Yeah.
Because see, the enemy right now, he's pounding and pounding.
Yeah.
And he's trying to destroy our faith. He's trying to tell us that things are not going to get better.
Uh-huh.
But what does the Word of God say? What does the Word of God say? We're going to come out of this.
Amen.
Not everybody's going to come out of it. The God's children are going to come out of this.
Amen.
Amen. See, that's a promise that I have to hold on to. You see, if you don't have anything to look forward to, when things get gloom and doom, then you can't fight. You have no reason to fight. But I've got hope. I've got hope in Jesus.
Yes.
I have no reason to lay down and roll over and say, I've had enough. I'm done. I quit. I got to keep pushing.
Yeah.
You see, I have a job to do.
Uh-huh.
I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord.
Yes.
He has dressed me for battle. He has prepared me for battle. He's saying, now is the time. Now is the time.
Yes.
The battle is here.
Bless her, Jesus.
So where's the rest of his army?
Come on. Hallelujah.
Bless him.
You see, the enemy can throw enough at you. He does that not only to deceive you, but to try to destroy your faith. But what does the Bible say about faith? It's impossible to please God without it.
Amen.
Faith is what saved you.
Yeah.
Faith is what put Jesus on the cross.
Amen.
Faith was what told Noah, go build that ark.
Come.
Before the rain even started.
Yes.
Faith was what took Abraham leading Isaac to the mount to sacrifice him. Because pleasing God was more important than anything else, and he wanted to be obedient.
Amen.
Faith is what led Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego into the burning fire,
yeah.
And they came out with not even a spill of smoke.
Amen.
Ma'am.
Faith. You gotta have faith.
Yeah.
You gotta keep the faith.
Yeah, come on.
You gotta keep pushing on.
Amen.
See, faith is hope. When you have faith, you know.
Yeah.
You know without a shadow of a doubt, I'm coming out of this.
Bless your Lord.
No matter what.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Faith was what caused Sarah to have a baby at an old age when she was no longer able to even conceive, let alone a child grow in her womb. But she gave birth, right?
Amen.
Because of faith.
Hallelujah.
So don't let the enemy steal your faith.
Come on.
Don't let the enemy tell you there is no hope. Amen?
Amen.
Because as long as there's breath in your body and you can cry out to Jesus, there's hope.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
But in order to be able to cry out to him, you've got to have faith.
Come on. Amen.
In order to have faith, you've got to read his word.
Yeah.
You've got to talk to him.
Right.
Because the more you talk to him, the more your faith increases, right?
Amen.
The more you study his word. Let's talk about Moses for a minute. Faith was what put Moses in the basket when they were coming after all the male children.
Amen.
Amen.
By faith, Moses' mother placed him in that basket.
Yep.
And she believed in her heart that God was sparing him.
Amen.
Faith was what caused Moses. why the enemy wants it. That's why the enemy wants to destroy your faith. Not only did faith lead Moses away from the Egyptians, faith protected him.
Amen.
When God sent the plague, the death angel, and he told him by faith, Moses went out and he put the blood upon his doorpost. So the death angel would pass over.
Amen.
Is the blood applied to your doorpost?
Come on, preach.
Thank the
Lord.
It was by faith that Moses stood at the Red Sea.
Yeah.
And the enemy surrounded him.
Bless her, Lord.
And God spoke to him and said, hold up thy staff.
Uh-huh.
And the Red Sea parted.
Yes.
It was by faith that kept his arm in the air. And by faith the Israelites crossed over on dry land.
Amen. Amen.
Untouched, unharmed.
Amen.
You think about the sea. You think about the lake and the river. When the water comes back, what's there? It's mud. You'll sink up to your eyeballs. They walked across it. Because Moses had faith in God. If he spoke to you tonight and told you to do something that was off the wall, could you do it? Do you have enough faith to do it? Moses was, Noah was faith-minded.
Yep.
When he started building that ark. Not a raindrop in sight. They wasn't making fun of him when the rain fell, was they?
No.
Don't let people discourage you. Don't let people make fun of you and try to weaken your faith.
Hallelujah.
It was by faith that the walls of Jericho fell down.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
They didn't do anything. They marched around that place, tooted their horn. But they believed because God told them on day 7 something big was going to happen.
Yeah.
If he told you today on day 7 something big is going to happen, would you listen to him?
Hallelujah.
I'm listening to him.
Bless you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
It was by faith that the harlot Rahab perished not.
Yeah.
Because she had faith. She took them at their word.
Yep.
If she helped them get free, they would spare her. And her faith saved her life. Amen. My faith will save my life. What else? What else? I can go on. I'll go on. Okay. What about Gideon?
Yeah.
He was at the threshing floor. And the angel said, thy mighty man of valor. Shrugged him off at first. Who are you talking to? And he took 300 men and he set his people free.
Amen.
If God spoke to you, Scott, and said, take Cameron, go down here to the jail, preach to them, and set them free, would you do it? Do you have enough faith? What about David? Did David have faith?
Come
on. He listened for God's instructions. That's having faith. You don't run out on your own and try to do something. You wait for God's instruction.
Amen.
And you complete his instruction. I started to say construction. Right?
Amen.
What about Samson? He was kind of vain in the beginning, wasn't he?
Yeah.
But what happened when he got took into captivity?
Wow.
He cried out to God one more time because he knew he had faith.
Uh-huh.
He said, God will hear me
and
he will answer me.
Bless your Lord.
And he done what he was sent out to do.
Amen.
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 So you got to keep increasing your faith.
Hallelujah.
Jesus said, faith the size of a grain of mustard seed.
Yep. Amen.
Well, the boy must be bad off. That's all it takes. If things aren't moving.
That's
all we need. Where is it? There's one in here.
Yeah, there's two.
Barely can see them. There's all kinds.
Yep.
Now you need one of them. country's still divided. Our governor's a warden. Things ain't great.
Sure.
What's going on? Lord, I believe.
Amen.
See, he's still waiting on something. You see, I've been studying and looking into some things. And it's in the Bible. You can read about it. How they used to take children and sacrifice them to an idol. That's still going on today. It's called abortion.
Yes. Amen.
We're chasing after money. Money's God.
What's your role?
We're spending too much time on Facebook. That's another idol. We come to church, we praise Jesus, we learn something, we go home and we sit down on it. We don't share it with anybody else. What's he waiting on? What's he waiting on? We got all these promises. All these promises, but we're struggling. What's going on? What's he waiting on? Is it making your mind go, You see, we weren't meant to come in here and just keep it in here. He said he wants his word spread from one end of the earth to the other. So how are we going to do that if we don't witness to anybody? If we don't share his word? He said God will give you boldness, young people, all people. God will give you boldness to stand in front of somebody and witness to them.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. I almost preached a sermon today in a patient's home. And his sister looked at me and said, "Preach on, sister." I said, "Don't get me started." I was up on my feet. And she said, "Preach on." And I said, "Don't encourage me, because I will." But I got to talk with her and him about my faith, about what I believe in. You see, I'm a nurse. I'm supposed to follow scientific practice-based evidence, okay, from scientists. But I know who created the body. Each organ taught the blood to flow this way.
Yeah.
Taught the veins to run this way. So I have a hard time when I'm told to trust science. You see, I struggle with that because I don't trust science. I've got no answers from science right now. What I've got is we don't really know yet.
Uh-huh.
This has been going on for almost a year now. They don't really know yet.
Yeah.
I tell you what I know. I know God is in control.
Yeah.
And I know God has protected me.
Yeah.
And I know Jesus' blood has been applied to me. There's something that can't cross that bloodline.
Yeah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
But the fear factor that has been placed in America today, it's ridiculous.
Amen.
I read the comments. They might as well get down on their hands and knees and bow and kiss the governor's feet. He's not holy. He's not to be worshipped. My God is to be worshipped.
Yes.
He can take this away.
Come on.
God can take this away.
Yes. Amen.
God is my protection. He is my healer.
Amen.
He is my deliverer.
Amen.
He is my boss.
Yeah.
He is my governor. He is my president.
Yes.
Yes, Lord.
It says, "Therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what you shall eat, or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body what you shall put on it. Is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment? Behold, the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are you not much better than they? Which one of you, by taking thought, can add one cubit unto his stature? And why take you thought for raiment? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. And yet I saw all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Wherefore, if God so clothe the grass of the field, which today is, and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye of little faith? Therefore take no thought, saying, what shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or withal shall we be clothed? For after all these things do the Gentiles seek. For your heavenly Father knoweth that ye need of all these things. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Take therefore no thought for tomorrow, for the morrow shall take thought for the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. So, he makes the grass grow, the birds never live without, especially not here because Pastor feeds them. The grass is going to wither away, but he makes sure it's there. The flowers, they're going to fade, but he makes sure they're there. How much more are we, say our word to him, than all those things?
Amen.
Good flow.
Keep right on. Keep right on. There's a blessing in store. There's a blessing in store for all of us.
Amen.
Just like my Aunt Sonia, there's a blessing in store for her. But we have to stay true. Fret not. Fret not.
Amen.
Don't worry about it. Comfort. 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 You see, Jesus has that comfort.
Amen.
See, when Christina said, I can hug her up and tell her I love her. Yeah. But when Jesus hugs you up and tells you he loves you.
Come on! Yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
Woo! Hallelujah!
Comfort, comfort.
Yeah.
Don't fret. Don't worry. Be not discouraged. There is nothing, nothing that can take us away from him.
That's right. Amen.
But ourselves.
That's right.
Nothing can separate us.
Amen.
God is for us. He's not against us.
Amen.
He created us to worship him.
Yes, Lord.
He created us to spend eternity in heaven with him.
Hallelujah.
Hell was made for the devil and his angels came.
Right.
Not for us.
That's right.
That's not our destiny.
Nope.
My destiny is a mansion in heaven.
Yes, Lord.
Because Jesus said, I go and I prepare a place. And if I go and prepare that place, I'm going to come back for you. My name's on it right now. Princess. And do you think for one second that I'm going to let the devil take my title?
Come on.
No, sir.
Hallelujah.
That's my title. Princess. Destined for glory. A mansion in heaven. To spend eternity with my Lord and Savior.
Yeah, come on.
Where I can spend every second of the day worshiping him.
Hallelujah.
Singing his praises.
Yes, Lord.
Blessing is to stand up here and look out and see you sitting in this congregation, eager to hear God's word. Eager to worship God.
Yeah.
That's a blessing.
Amen.
You see, big things happen with small prayers.
Amen.
I'm going to give you an example. Right here, some of them sit.
Yep.
A couple of them are out sick tonight. It started with God, what can we do to make them feel they are important to your kingdom? And then it began to prosper. And now, most Wednesday nights, we get to sit back.
Yeah.
And we get to listen to them lead worship.
Amen.
That's a blessing.
Yes, it is a blessing.
A blessing is a place to come and worship. It's waking up each morning with a roof over your head, shoes on your feet,
yeah,
a way to get to work. These are all blessings.
Amen.
These are all things that we need, right?
Amen.
And God supplies. He gives you the strength to do that job. Or He gives you the strength to work that job long enough to draw a check from it. I see. Draw a disability, that's a blessing.
Amen.
You work long enough and you put it in there. God says, now sit down and rest. Here it is.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
It's a blessing. So you just got to hold on to His promises. You got to put the devil under your feet where he belongs. Throw him out of your house. Throw him out of your bank account. Throw him out of your job.
Amen.
Throw him out of your children's rooms.
Yeah. Amen. Come on.
Rebuke the slothness.
Come on.
Of sleeping all day. You see, I call them saved, sanctified, and filled with the Holy Ghost. That's my children.
Amen.
So when the enemy tries to tell me they're slothful, no, they're not. They're workers for the kingdom of heaven.
Yeah. Amen.
That's what my children are. When he tries to tell me I'm no good, I'm royalty. I'm
Amen.
A princess, and my kingdom is waiting on me.
Amen.
And I will put you under my feet because you will not stand in my way of getting there.
Hallelujah.
That's me looking into his territory and telling him what I think. Because he's not strong enough to take me down. Is he strong enough to take you down, Ernie? You see, because God gives his angels command.
Right.
He tells them, that is my child, uh-huh, and you gather around her.
Uh-huh.
And you keep right on
walking.
Yeah. Because they're in front of you and you don't even realize. And they've got their swords drawn, and the demons and the devil is bowing.
Amen.
Amen.
So keep on walking.
Amen.
Keep on pressing. Don't listen to the enemy.
Nope.
Comfort. Comfort ye. There's comfort. We are wrapped up. We are clothed in his righteousness. Keep your heads up.
Yes.
Don't look down. Don't back up.
Amen.
Keep pressing forward.
Yeah.
Amen.
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 That's all I got.
Praise the Lord. Thank you.
So I think tonight, in light of all things that are going on, we need to pray a little harder.
Amen.
We need to pray a little louder.
Yes.
We especially need to pray a little louder and a little harder for those that are not here tonight. Amen.
Amen.
That is being attacked
in
their body. Amen.
Hallelujah.
We need to pray for the churches that have been attacked by the coronavirus.
Yes, Lord.
Because what's going on is the enemy's trying to tell us that God does not have our protection in his house.
Come on.
Yeah. But I don't believe that for one second.
Yes, Lord.
This
Hallelujah.
Is the safest place to me that I can be.
Amen.
Amen.
Right here.
Yes.
She just wanted somebody to stand in for her, Stephanie and Bobby. Wanted somebody to stand in for her in faith.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, we will.
All right. Praise the Lord.
Sorry, you want to get some music?
Hallelujah.
And we're going to pray.
Let me end it because it's just
We need somebody to stand.